first thing we want to do to make our scheme maneuver overlays is make sure we've got all of our materials together, right? So I've got my map here opened up to the relevant part. I've got my markers, all right, and all the colors I'm going to need. And it's important to make sure that you get the permanent markers. They're the black ones from this company, and not water erasable markers or dry erase markers, because those will smudge off if there's any kind of moisture or if you get your hand just rubbing on it too much. So you gotta use the permanent markers to make sure it's gonna hold up out in the field. At least get the fine. I really like to use the sharp, the S ones, 0.4 millimeter tip. So you get a nice precise line and be able to draw in when you're doing your small lettering and things. That'll all fit in there. It's good to have one of these eraser markers. All right, this is just an alcohol pen and it'll erase what was there. So that's something that's available, good for small lines. It's good to have two alcohol swabs. These are nice because you can get them from unit supply or from your medics. Usually you can get a strip of a couple of them and they're easy to throw in a bag or just slide them into your notebook, or if you keep like a flight book with all your info in it for your platoon, you can get some of these and just slip them in. That way, you know, they're small, they're light, you can kind of use them one at a time, just as you need them for larger areas. You can do an entire sheet with them if you needed to out in the field. And then in the rear areas, you can just have a bottle of rubbing alcohol and some wipes to erase an entire sheet to reuse it later if you need to. To get started, first thing we're going to do is review our COA statement and sketch, remind ourselves what we planned earlier. All right, we're going from the assembly area to the ORP, there's an LD, some phase lines. Our ORPs behind phase line Birmingham, assault positions behind phase line Camden. All right, we've got somebody moving up to an LPOP looking over an interdiction mission. We're going to have two squads in support by fire and our assault to do the destruction on objective Tiger, right? So we can review our tasks and purposes there. All right. So we've got ourselves caught up on what we're trying to do. Next thing I want to look at is my AO overlay that came from my company commander. I'm going to line up the crosshairs there. All right, so we copied this over onto a piece of acetate. And now we can see here's our assembly area, here's our objective, here's our platoon boundary with third platoon on the one side, here's our other boundary. And that's the battalion boundary between 4th 2nd platoon. Here is 1st battalion 50 deuce on the other side. All right, so we need a little bit of coordination to find out who's our adjacent platoon leader, so we can do echelon coordination. But we don't need to know that for our scheme maneuver right at the moment. Okay, we just need to know that that's there. All right, so I get myself a fresh sheet of acetate. All right, I'm actually going to line these up to make it easier on myself. Make sure we're on the crosshairs appropriately. All right, now I get out my black marker. And what I want to do, I lost my alignment. What I want to do first, if we're going to start with, all right, our phase one, we know that we're going to be in the assembly area. So that's why I need the information from the AO overlay to make sure I get that in the right spot. All right, make my crosshairs and number them. All right, so for phase one, I know that we're going to be in our assembly area. A strike. Okay, so I know that we're going to be there, all right. And then, now, for our phase one overlay, if we had the information, we might be showing where we're going to pick up chow, where's a POL point, where do we go for fuel, where is the rehearsal site, things like that if we know where they are. This example, we don't have any specific information that they're not in the assembly area with us, so we can kind of make that assumption for class that all that's in here. So we're going to be located inside the assembly area, so our phase one overlay is, you know, kind of unexciting. that's a lot of wasted space, so we can combine this with our phase two overlay, which is our movement up to the ORP. So when I consulted our COA sketch, our ORP is going to be right behind this phase line, Birmingham, and we're going to have to cross the other phase line. So I want to make sure that I get those phase lines captured for this particular phase. So now I've got my LD, my phase line Aberdeen, my phase line Birmingham, and I've gone ahead and included those AO boundaries, not because I need to copy the entire AO overlay, but just because our assembler is way over here, and you know, I don't want to try moving through third platoon sector to get in there. I have to understand that you know, where these boundaries are in order to do my movement phase. So I'll make sure they're there. Now I'm probably going to go ahead and make sure that those are all tight. Everything's labeled. All right. Great. So now I've got that copied and I know what is relevant for this phase. So now I've got my working phase overlay. All right. And that'll look like that so far. Now I need to figure out where I'm going to move, and a good way to do that is to look at my GTAO that I did earlier. All right, so I'm going to line that one up on the map and line up the one that I'm working on so that they don't, whoop. All right, and we line them up with the map underneath. All right, so now I can see what I plan, and I make sure that the one I'm working with is the one that's on top and the GTAO is underneath. All right, so I got to plan my route, and where am I going to put my ORP? So I know I want to be behind phase line Birmingham. All right, my objective's over here. Okay, now there's a piece of key terrain here, which means it's something that I want to hold that. So no matter what, I want something there. All right, if I neglect the key terrain, then that means I'm just ceding something advantageous to the enemy that could have been advantageous to me. All right, I don't want to do that. I don't want them to have an advantage, and I want to have every advantage I can get. So I need something on that key terrain, whether it's an OP or something else. But that might be a great place to go ahead, and let's just put our ORP right on that. I'm going to take that and force and make sure I have that, all right, because that's a nice piece of key terrain right before I get to the objective over here. All right, now I've got to figure out how I'm going to get to the ORP. All right, now I've got my avenues of approach laid out. So here's avenue of approach one, avenue of approach two. So really with two of them, that comes down to I've got a primary and an alternate route. So now we just have to plan this out as an actual route. Now here's my LD. So everything behind the LD is just kind of administrative movement, so I don't need to worry too much about it. So I just got to figure out where I'm going to start from. And I can label, all right, I know I'm going to start out up here. And it looks like this route 12... goes through well, that's our platoon boundary, right? So I don't want to be right on the road. I don't want to move on a road anyway, but I can handrail the road, all right, and know that we're going to move something like this, right? We're just going to handrail the road inside that avenue of approach. I'm going to keep handrailing the road up to here, all right? Now, here's the LD line, and that's a lake. I'm going to have some trouble. We're going to have to move like along the LD to get there, right? Which really means that over here on 293 is where we're going to start our movement because we're on the LD the whole time. So I'm going to just label this SP for start point. All right, that's my start point. So I know where the start point of my route is. So here's my assembly area. We can just administratively get yourselves over the start point. And now I've got my route laid out this far. All right. Now, every here and then, we're going to need some checkpoints to make sure we're keeping track of where we're at. And there's a road intersection between Route 12 and Route 14 down here. I like my checkpoints to be something that are visible, that I can find easily on the terrain, so that I know that I'm in the right spot. So here is checkpoint one. All right, right there. It's not the neatest, but it's legible. So right when we get handrail in the road, just off the intersection, will be our first checkpoint. All right, we also know that we're on the south side of the lake as we turn around it, so it's kind of an easy spot to recognize that we're there. So squads will be able to call in as they make that turn and start heading north again. Now, if I'm taking my, let's say I want Avenue of Approach 1 to be my primary. So we're going to go right along the bottom of this ridge. All right, and we're going to have to link up here. All right, that gets me that far. Now, we don't have to get ourselves all the way up to the ORP because we've got a nice tool called a release point. All right, so we just label this RP and mark a release point here. So we go from our start point to our release point, and when we reach the release point, head into the ORP, whatever's most makes the most sense once we're there. Okay, and we're all behind our phase line. Now I need to think about an alternate route. I've got this other avenue of approach that comes over this way. So what we want to do is take that, and when we do that, we do a dotted line, and we're going to handrail this other road across the ridge. I'll make a small correction here. All right, get out our little alcohol marker and rub that off. All right, we're going to handrail the road until we get to this little stream. The little stream will be our spot to cut over to this other road. And then we'll handrail along the road and then the ridge line. Oop, I drew it too far. So we'll make another little correction here. Okay, now we already used a release point, and this is a secondary plan. So I'm just going to label this one as a checkpoint. Okay. All right. So that's a checkpoint at the end of that one. Now we've got checkpoint one. I probably want to go ahead and... here is an intersection where we got to decide, are we going to go south or are we going to keep going along our alternate? So that's a good spot to go ahead and say, I need a checkpoint two. Okay. And then making this turn over here, let's say that's somewhere I want my squad leaders to call it in. So that becomes checkpoint three if they go that route, which makes this one checkpoint four. I can put the four in there. So now I've got checkpoints one, two, three, and four. All right. Now the only important thing that I haven't done yet is, not the only, but the next important thing I gotta do is a casualty collection point. So if something happens to us, where are we gonna go to? I wanna be near the road networks that are gonna get us back to the assembly area, where the ambulances are, whatever we're doing. And I'm gonna go ahead and say, you know what? If we fall back, it doesn't matter what route we're on, but we'll go ahead and put it over here. Now, this is getting kind of cluttered, so I'm just going to go ahead and make my CCP symbol over here, but then I can do a little extension line. That means that it's at the tip of that line, so we'll take it right down, all right, and then they can come get us along this road and take us back up, but we got to get it to the casualty collection point there, all right. Now I can take my avenues of approach off of here, line my map back up. All right, and now we can see we've got our route, we've got our alternate, we've got checkpoints along the way, we've got a start point. So that's pretty much it for a plan. Now I have to make sure that I represent where are my units on this overlay. All right, now it might be easier to see that because that's just something I don't need to tie the train, I need to tie it to the overlay. For phase one, we can just kind of say everybody's in the assembly area, right? Or we could just show the icons and just draw a line into there. We do need to do something to show our order of march. All right, that's kind of a crowded spot, so I'm going to go ahead and show it up over this way. All right, and I'm going to start with just saying, all right, I need to get my four squads drawn out. Right, and I know that the first one is going to be first, and we are second platoon. I want to follow them with weapons, second platoon, and then second squad and third squad. Okay, and then I can go ahead and show that we've got some movement here. All right. Okay, so I can see that we're going to come out of the assembly area down here. I know that I'm going to follow the exact route, but I can get the idea of what order we're leading with first as we come out of the assembly area. All right. So now that I've got that done, I have to get all my administrative information onto the overlay. Now we have our completed scheme and maneuver overlay. All right, showing what we have to do. We can put it right on our map and get an idea of all the movement that's going to happen.